Still a little hot in Phoenix, so haven't done a video in a long time. But changing out the Rancho diff for the next Venture front diff skid. A lot different, a little bit thicker. You saw the video for the rear back there. So I'm gonna pop this off and then I'm just gonna do an actual real-time install so you can see kind of what that took. This thing's taken a good beating. It's supposed to do, hit a couple of rocks on it. Actually, depending on how you look at it, it did get take a nice hit here. It has a slight bend in it. So this one is just gonna chalk it up to saving my diff and going in the garbage. But all right, that's where we're gonna go from right here. Here's what we're gonna do. It's 11:28, so I'll do some of the basic stuff, pull it off here, touch it up, a little black spray paint, get it set up to put the skid on. I do it right because it's heavy, let the paint dry. So 11:40, everything's dry here, got the bolts out, we're ready to go. So gonna be a lot of sliding around and then we'll get it fixed up. Here's what we've got so far. Got a piece that goes over the top. It is tapered. So when you see the taper, I get these things in raw steel from Next Venture, and Dan and the guys really make a solid product. All the black I paint with engine paint. It's all primed, sanded, cleaned. Cleaned before it's primed, and then sanded and cleaned after it's primed, and then painted up here. Then I wrapped it right around it so it just looks pretty under here, because why not? So the taper tapers away with the diff, slides up over here nicely, and all these pieces sit right on the diff. So there are two tabs here on either side of it, and you'll see it when you put it on, that slide right up here like that, just like the back. So we'll get that on first. And then what we learned from the last time, and we'll try it two different ways this time, is that this thing right here, you can see I did the same here, engine black on the inside, primed, etc., all of the unfilled, non-welded seams that were bent were all filled in. I let all the primer seep into that. This thing baked out here in the Arizona sun for days, literally, with each coat, and then it gets harder and harder, and then did the black here. So because this thing weighs who knows what, I'll put it in the description, but pounds, let's say. We're gonna slip this thing in here like this, and then tens of pounds, 30 probably. And then we're gonna take the bottle jack so that we can get it up here and hold it up here, and then be able to put on the inside of it, because it's just too heavy to deal with. So, is it here for a second? So, we get two pieces that go on the inside. Match up with the holes nicely here. There is clearly a right and a left, because there are two holes that are closer and one that's further away. So you can mark them if you want. They hang really nicely right on the two inner pieces, inner braces of this here. So then the idea is take those number 8 bolts and washers that come with it. I'll put the torque specs now. You just saw me empty that. Holes, but there are only 4 here, so we'll see how that goes. Like with the rear, this gets very heavy. So if I can get it in here with 1, I will attempt it. Got it falling and breaking my head, and I can't. Some painter's tape to keep it from pulling away. The idea is not to get this thing to lever the front of the diff. And so, in so doing, this height wise. See if we can't. Get a bolt or 2 in the front of the diff and keep this thing sort of level. And there's a spacer that goes in here. That it looks like maybe it's placed. spacer. Fits nicely. There is a certain way it's supposed to go. So, this last time. Because of the inside of this being so damn well made, it's not a bad thing. It's cut out with the braces all in the right spot. So this just kind of, when you get it right, it just kind of clicks in nicely, as you can see right here. And then all the bolts just fit. So again, kudos to Dan and the crew. Once you get it, it's somewhat easy. Gotta get all these in just wiggle tight. expected. So I'm going to do that really carefully because I don't want to strip out anything. That one's going in nicely now. And yes, I did clean them before I put them in there. So that threaded in there nicely. Alright, now it's putting these number 8 bolts in here. We'll get an answer why there are 5 bolts, 6 holes, 4 places to put it. There's also 6 washers. So, you know, maybe we're just missing a bolt. Which is fine. It happens. It's not going to hurt it for right now. One washer. Front of it. Alright, with this thing nicely propped like this, much easier. Looks like this fits. Again, once you get these going, this stuff fits so well that I'm literally finger tightening these bolts into here. Okay, so the blue tape idea is pointless. I'll show you why in a minute. But it's because it is made so damn well that it's made to sit right on the diff. I think I'm actually thinking of the way it is so nicely built and able to fit in here. I believe Modell said the same thing. Alright. So, hand tighten. I'm going to bring this over here and give you guys an idea. Tight that is. There's the other hole that isn't in there. These two fit nicely in here. Right off of here, past all of this. I mean, and so you can see what's going on. Pretty damn cool. cool. I'm gonna put this bolt in this one. Maybe that's supposed to hold that in there some way, shape, or form. Tighten down to the right torque specs. So I'm going to assume the rear torque specs are to be used for the front torque specs. And the M8 bolts should be at 30 pounds. And the coarse thread bolts up front should be at 33. Dan, if you ever see this, let me know if those are right. That's what I got for the rear, and we'll modify that if need be. So, I'll do the front to 38, and then we'll be done. course, I'm going to mark all these bolts so that make sure there is any movement later. Three. Hands are bare. Old 18. Real time.